the Seattle of Speaking Objects, which is presented here in the Project Art Center in Dublin, is a work which I started already working on in 2012. Mm-hmm. In that time, it had rather different character. I was using props, different objects that were already used by their previous owners, and I would create a kind of stage situation, or almost a theater situation in a gallery space, where there will be eight actors on the stage, people who never acted before with no acting experience, and also people who are quite shy to share their stories. And the idea behind it was very much inspired by, on one hand, by these psychodrama sessions, which is a technique where patients or people with different communication problems or mental illnesses are using several props or theatrical elements to talk through them, or to help them to open up about their problems or difficulties, or mm-hmm. to share their biographies and so on. The other inspiration point was Jiří Kroha, Theater of Things. Jiří Kroha is a respected architect, but also stage designer from a modernist period in former Czechoslovakia. And he would do this about, I think, 12 or 14 aquarelles or drawings that would show objects which would interact with each other, and they would be telling stories. And I very much liked all these inspiration points somehow influenced the final work. And so in the previous practice, it worked in the sense that there would be a theater performance where there would always be always just one performer or one actor on the stage, and then they would be sharing all kind of stories with the audience. They would have a very, very diverse character. Either they would be real stories that would be describing their communication problems, struggling with pronunciation or stammering and so on. But then I somehow realized that actually what creates the piece is much more the objects and the voices, that actually, because also you couldn't see the performers that much, it's much more sharing the stories through some mediator or through some other object or some other element that would help them to speak out. So the second stage was that I was, and this is also what is presented here in a completely new coordinate, is that I would just show a number or group of objects that would always have a voice, an audio speaker in them, and they would share the story without a live performer hiding somewhere. So basically what you see here, you enter a black room, and one by one the objects are approaching you with their stories. Very often it's they present a fragment of a story, then there is another object jumping in with their story impatiently, waiting to share it with you as well. And each of the object has its own voice. In the previous installations, I would always show the piece in a gallery space, which is of course something completely different. While here, I have the feeling that it finally found its right location. That you have all this, even though it's very invisible because it's placed in the dark, but it has this the theater apparatus, especially on the ceiling, or the lightning and the structure around. And I think it's really the perfect stage for the objects to speak about their difficulties. What was important for me was that there is actually not this like hierarchical division between the audience sitting and looking to something, that there is not this distance, which I actually used quite intentionally before in the first stage, or in the first example that I was mentioning, where actually we had a stage and then the audience was sitting and looking at the performers stepping on the stage and sharing the stories. While in this case, for me, it was much more important to create this kind of like very intimate presentation of the stories and create the situation when you can really walk around them, and it's basically always just like one-to-one conversation, or not really a conversation, but you can stand quite close to the object as if you would stand with another person on the street, or you would sit close to him and you would be just sharing stories. Also important element is the lightning, which this is maybe the theatrical element, which also helps a lot and creates a kind of dynamic, and also the whole structure of the speech that the light is always on only when the object is actively speaking, and then once it ends the story or is being interrupted by the other object, the light goes off, and then another object has the chance to speak. So